We got bantamweight Muay Thai. A solid Ooh takes on Masayoshi Tsuhashi. Ooh is 2 years older, 3 inches shorter. The weight relatively equal as Myanmar takes on Japan. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. A 10-point must system will be in play. As three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws, no grappling allowed.
From the blue corner, Masayoshi Tsuhashi.
Masayoshi Tsuhashi. This 30-year-old has 19 victories to his name. Represents the Free Fighter Gym from Japan. Coming into this one off a win. This is a huge moment for him as well, representing Japan on the global stage.
Oh, such an interesting backstory to Masayoshi Tsuhashi. Found his way to Muay Thai after being involved in a string of activities, including playing baseball in high school. Even thought about going into pro wrestling, but he was too light to do that. Found his way through kickboxing, inevitably, to Muay Thai. This is his first time in Thailand. Can't wait for this guy's debut.
For me, it's nice to see him again because I know him from Japan. We do a lot of our training at a gym in Nishikawaguchi in Saitama, Wheeler Sakurek Gym. And although we were in different weight classes, we were in the gym a lot together. We got to talk, you know, so it's really great to see him again. He has a very sharp Muay Thai style, you know, and he knows how tough his opponent is. He said he wants to show not just his punching ability, but that he can use those compact, close range techniques, those elbows and those knees against that pressure fighter who is undoubtedly going to be coming to take his head off.
Tsuhashi has been training in these small gloves in anticipation for this debut, exactly like Brian McGrath said, looking to intercept the pressure of his opponent, land with the elbows and knees on the inside. His compatriot went down in the very first round. Can Masayoshi Tsuhashi turn it around? Making his one Friday fight's debut, taking his time on top of the legendary Lupini ring here. Masayoshi Tsuhashi.
From the red corner, Solei Uu.
Solei Uu. An incredible 71 victories, only 3 losses. This 32-year-old trains at a Dojo Yard Leftweight Club. A former national leftweight champion, a leftweight golden belt champion. An incredible 68 out of 71 victories via knockout. Both father and older brother were fighters, and he's looking to make them proud here tonight.
Oh, Johnny, this man is a living legend. The state of Mon, this man has been through so much adversity. Can't even begin to tell you what it means to him to be here after 20 years of fighting pro lightweight. Here, tell us a little bit about his style, Brian.
I mean, it's hard to believe 20 years of bare knuckle fights. Headbutts are legal. You know, the only way a winner is decided is if there is a knockout. So it would be an understatement to say that he is prepared for this small glove battle that he's about to walk into. He told us when we spoke to him, you know, I'm not a big kicker, not a big kneer, I don't use my elbows a lot. I'm a big puncher. He knows his strength. He knows the weapon that he needs to use, and that's his hands. He's looking to get close, put it at punching range, and really rain the pain on his opponent, Masayoshi, who doesn't have experience in these little gloves.
Solei Uu supports his family with his money from fighting. He encourages the young children in his family to stay in school and pays for their school fees when they cannot afford it. Very excited. The 32 two-year-old Soo Lee Woo here on One Friday Fights. This is going to be an absolute banger in the bantamweight Muay Thai division. A quick prayer before he goes over the top ropes. Soo Lee Woo will take on Masayoshi Tsuhashi.
Now, this match is 3 3-minute rounds of bantamweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Free Fighter, representing Japan, Masayoshi Tsuhashi. And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Doyoya Lightweight Club, holding a fight record of 71-3 and a 96% win rate, representing Myanmar, Man of Steel, Soo Lee Woo.
ทั้งคู่นะชกให้เต็มที่มีน้ำใจนักกีฬาล้มไม่ซ้ำไม่ดำฟาวเก็บป่ะ
just
ready ครับ
Refree Crit Sattapontu in charge of this bantamweight Muay Thai clash. Only the best of the best in the world are invited to ONE Championship, the world's largest stage of martial arts, representing the pinnacle of fighting. Tsuhashi in the blue corner, Soo Lee Woo in the red.
Soo Lee Woo, the man of steel from Myanmar, already looking comfortable in there. Such an interesting style. Move forward style that he has.
100% Achilles stylistically. The matchup is so interesting. I'm really curious to see how Soo Lee Woo is going to close the distance. What techniques is he going to use? What sort of combinations will he throw? I know Tsuhashi is looking to be at this range here with the kicks, and he's already looking very comfortable with that left body kick, and it is landing.
Tsuhashi fighting on the outside with a left kick. Banging that knee up the middle. Soo Lee Woo with the pressure. Pushing his Japanese opponent up into the ropes.
Soo Lee Woo, he told us that he likes to please the crowd. We asked him about his fighting style. He told us he wants to bring the exciting fights. He wants to go for the finish. It's going to be difficult against Tsuhashi, because he really does look like he's starting to use his range and his distance well.
Tsuhashi's doing a great job right now, but he needs to make sure that he does not let his guard down even a second throughout this entire fight, because Soo Lee Woo is so tough. He's got so much experience in such a brutal fighting sport that he can handle it. So Tsuhashi needs to really be on his game here and not do anything too crazy. The jumping knee's all right, but could possibly be a little bit risky, and a risk that he just doesn't need to take.
Tsuhashi very active with that left side, going forward with the left kick and the left knee. But again, Soo Lee Woo looking for a big right hand, trying to close the distance. Another nice knee there, landing for the Japanese Tsuhashi.
Soo Lee Woo starting to find some success to the body. You can already see the redness of Tsuhashi. And there you see Soo Lee Woo temporarily hitting the canvas, right back up, back to work. Nice teep there on the top of the thigh from Tsuhashi, from Soo Lee Woo.
The technique here that Tsuhashi is using is underneath the punches, you know, that Soo Lee Woo is throwing. He's leading in with his right hand. Tsuhashi is meeting him with the knee and keeping the guard high, and it can be very effective. We saw the last knee that he threw knocked Soo Lee Woo down, so I think that's a good strategy from Tsuhashi, and he just needs to make sure that he keeps that guard up and he sets those knees up with a jab. 1-2.
Tsuhashi looking for the counter elbow on the left side again. It is Soo Lee Woo with the pressure going forward. And Matador in the bull in the first round. Soo Lee Woo, an incredible 68 out of 71 victories via knockout. Tsuhashi working well on the outside, Achilles.
Yeah, pretty even first round there. I think both fighters were trying to implement their strategy, both showing well-rounded, good experience. There you see the high kick going up top, connecting for the Japanese fighter there.
Yeah, you know, both guys landing some good, clean shots. I think the knees from Tsuhashi were a bit more outstanding, especially with, you know, driving his opponent to the ground there. But in the second round, you know, I can only imagine that So Liu is gonna just come out banging.
This is the world's largest martial arts platform, and winning convincingly gives them the greatest opportunity to join the ranks of the best strikers in the world in one championship. We enter the second round here of this bantamweight Muay Thai clash. Again, it is So Liu Oh pressuring forward. Tsuhashi on the lateral movement and a strong left side.
I like the way Tsuhashi just throws that leg up. Seems to be connecting every time, but the relentless forward pressure from So Liu Oh now in the clinch, getting to work. Good to see.
You know, Tsuhashi just has to be careful that he doesn't get caught in the same pattern all the time. The knees are affected, but he could mix up how he throws them a little bit. You know, throw a low kick here and there. He just needs to not get caught in the trap of being predictable.
So Liu Oh on the inside, the right hand has been his best weapon. He's going to the body, looking to loop over the left hook, but Tsuhashi again, great control of the distance and the range, keeping his Myanmar opponent on the outside with those long range kicks, the push kick. Oh, and a head kick there as well. And a nice thump there from So Liu Oh.
Such a good example is So Liu Oh to the youngsters in his village in the Mon state of Myanmar. And here you can see his relentless will to try and finish this fight, hunting Tsuhashi down with every step.
This is what So Liu needs to do. He needs to make it a bit more of a dogfight. Press forward, clinch up, throw those elbows, catch Tsuhashi with a check hook as he goes to throw the knee. This is where he's gonna have better luck.
Ah, inside fighting by So Liu Oh, showing us that durability that he is known for. Want to work on the inside now.
This is the kind of never give up attitude and mentality. This is the lifestyle that So Liu Oh lives. This man has never given up a day in his life, and this is what you're seeing here in the ring.
It's really important that Tsuhashi just stays composed, sticks to what he's doing. I'd like to see him use the jab just a little bit more, and maybe throw a kick down low, just mix it up. This is not where he wants to be, getting punched with his back against the ropes.
Punishing pressure here from So Liu Oh. Trying to overwhelm Tsuhashi. Going to work on the inside. The referee breaks him up, but So Liu Oh marches forward, hungry for his first victory here on World Friday Fights.
Oh, Tsuhashi falls to the canvas there. Nice timing on the counter from So Liu Oh. And again, sit back down, says So Liu Oh, as he's starting to dominate this second round.
You know, great time and conditioning here from So Liu Oh. Ooh, he, you know, is really doing a great job. The timing of the front kick, and I think it's his conditioning at this point. He's in great shape, and Tsuhashi is just looking a little bit fatigued.
Strong finish to the round for So Liu Oh. The face of Tsuhashi now battered, bruised. A huge round for the 32-year-old So Liu Oh.
So Liu Oh starting to pick up the pace here in the second round. Gonna be really interesting to see what happens in the third. But take a look at the action from the second. The high kick, as usual, landing for Tsuhashi. But the poker face from So Liu Oh, he just walks through those strikes. Look at him, just dirty boxing there, trying to grab the neck and land strikes. This really is amazing to watch.
This was the best range and definitely the best round so far for So Liu Oh here close, making it a dogfight. He is going to try to do that again for sure in this third round.
One Friday Fights is for established fighters, for up-and-comers who want to earn a shot at the highest levels in the world. In the flagship one, a strong second round for So Liu Oh. Can Masayoshi Tsuhashi turn it around in this third and final round? Again, clubbing on the inside, So Liu Oh going to work on the inside.
So Liu Oh now starting to show that he wants this. He's carrying the weight of a nation on his shoulders. The whole of Myanmar will be watching and cheering this man on. This man is a legend in his country, and he's come to the pinnacle of Muay Thai here at Wan Lumpini to show that he can make it to the top.
You can see the damage on Tsuhashi's face. You can see the fatigue. You know, he really needs to dig deep here. Not just let that left kick go, but that left hand as well. He needs it down. He needs to find that chin somehow.
Suffocating pressure there from Suli. Oh, look at that smile on his face. Evading the left kick of Tsuhashi. Goes right back to work here, but that's a nice counter there from Tsuhashi on the inside.
Suli Oh has been fighting since he was a small child. He has been around the circuit for a long time. He's been waiting for this moment. And he's starting to put the pressure on Tsuhashi. And the question is, will Tsuhashi break?
Yeah, Tsuhashi needs to find a way to get that distance back, keep himself off the ropes. You know, it's a southpaw orthodox matchup, so he could do that with some footwork. But at this point, Sou Liu is doing a great job of getting into that clinching range, maybe even eating a shot or two on the way in, but then dominating here.
Sou Liu trying to melt Tsuhashi. Leading up from the nose now. Tsuhashi trying to figure out a way to stop this forward momentum of Sou Liu. Short left kick there, but not enough power to stop the train that is Sou Liu.
Oh, and he just walks right through him there, starting to gain more and more confidence. Oh, the body shot! He's got Tsuhashi hurt. He's winded him. That came out of nowhere as he was grabbing his neck, and he just shot right up to the gut as he floored Tsuhashi for the count.
The pressure is just relentless, and you can see now the second wind from Sou Liu driving. He wants to finish so bad.
Tsuhashi covering up, and down goes Tsuhashi again. Sou Liu with the third round TKO. Non-stop pressure in the second and third round. Finds his first victory here. A one Friday fight, victory number 72 for the 32-year-old.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legend is real. We have witnessed what Sou Liu told us he was gonna do. He was gonna come out, he was gonna please the crowd, and he was gonna get the finish, and that is what he did.
It really came down to conditioning and tenacity. The knee and the elbow there, the right hand, just completely wearing Tsuhashi down with his toughness and his hands, and just his tenacity at that close range. Really hard to fight someone that's just all over you like a wet blanket. And there's the damage, you can see it. That body shot just completely changing the rhythm.
The finish from the Man of Steel from Myanmar. He showed early that he could take the pressure and the pain from Tsuhashi and came out on top.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the third round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Sou Liu!
Sou Liu, bringing the pride and joy to the country of Myanmar. Our neighbors just across the border. And the relentless pressure in the end was just too much for Masayoshi Tsuhashi. He had to yield to the Man of Steel from Myanmar.
Sou Liu, your pressure was incredible. What was your motivation coming into this bout?
I prepared since 2 months ago, and it is very hard to try one championship. So this time, this is the chance for him to try one. So that's why he thinks he went for this tonight.
Well, Solio, guess what? You just picked up a 350,000 baht bonus from Chatri Sidyotong.
He
wants to say thank you to everybody, to his boss, and to ONE Championship, and he's so happy right now.
Can't wait to see you back in action. Lumpini Stadium, give it up for your winner, Solio!
Well-deserved bonus from Mr. Chatri Sityotong out here changing lives. Solio able to go back to his village and provide for the locals there. You see the body shot and the follow-up knee. Relentless pressure from the man of steel. Had the Japanese fire on the back foot the whole time he was in there. Amazing performance from the debutante from Myanmar. Ladies and gentlemen, do not go anywhere. The big boys are up next as Max.